Hi, I'm Gretel, Customer Success for Comet. In this video, I'll walk you through the steps to configure a disk image backup with Comet and how to restore your backups. Let's get started. With Comet, you can backup disk image on Windows devices with full functionality supported on Windows 7 or Windows Server 2008 R2 and later. Comet will store the disk image files in VMDK format, which can be restored onto physical hardware, a virtual machine, or a cloud environment. There are several ways that you can restore a disk image backup, which I will show you later. You can configure a disk image backup and perform a restore either from the Comet server's web UI or through the client software. We will cover both interfaces in this video. Now, here are the steps to configure a disk image backup with Comet. Take note that backing up disk image with Comet will incur a fee. In this demo, we will set up a disk image backup in the Comet server. Then we will show the client software interface later when walking through the restore options. In the Comet server, go to the user that you want to set this up for and click on the Protected Items tab. Click on Add Protected Items here and choose the device that you want to backup. Here, choose Disk Image and you can rename this backup here. Click on Next when done. This is where you can select the items to backup. Comet will exclude unused space from the disk in the backup, but turning on the option here will include the unused space which could be used for forensic data recovery, but at the expense of slowing down the backup. Click on the green folder here to start selecting the items to backup. You can either just choose all drives, or you can expand the drop-down to select or deselect specific disks. If the disk was selected here, Comet will backup the partition table and bare metal restore will be possible. If only partitions are selected, then only those partitions are backed up and can be restored to an existing partition layout. If there is any change to a partition of a drive, it will cause that drive to be recognized differently in Comet. If you had selected such a drive, Comet will warn you that the drive can no longer be found and you would need to reselect the drives or partitions. Click on Save after you've made your selection, and then click on Next to move on to the next tab. Here, you can configure commands that run before or after this protected item is backed up. You can set up your backup schedules here. Click on the plus sign to start and configure your backup schedule. Choose the storage location you want to direct your backups to. You can set up several backup schedules pointing to different locations, either to on-prem or to cloud storage. Click on the Time tab. Here, you can add the actual schedules. Click on the plus sign. Choose the frequency of your backups and fill in the details. Click on Save when done. Click on Save here, then click on Next to move on. Click on Save to finish the setup. Now, let us run a manual backup. Make sure you are pointing to the storage vault where you would like this backup to be stored, and click on Backup. With Comet, the first backup is a full one, and the next backups are incremental through our chunking technology. We explain this in a separate video, which I have linked below. That was successful. We now have a disk image backup, which we can restore. A disk image backup is an excellent measure for disaster recovery, because when a Windows device fails, you can easily get started on a new device through a bare metal restore. Here are the steps to create the recovery media that you can boot into on a bare metal device. Before we get into that, let me just quickly show you how to set up a disk image backup from the client software. Click on Create New Protected Item and follow the prompts. Similar to the Comet server, you can also select the items to protect in the client software. You can set command lines here. You can set up new backup schedules or edit existing ones. you can rename the protected item before finishing the setup. Now, let us create a USB recovery media and an ISO image file from the client software. Click on the ellipsis here, then click on Create Recovery Media. With Comet, you can create a bootable recovery WinRE USB, WinRE ISO, or a full Windows OS environment through Windows to Go. We will go through these options in more detail next. Let us start with creating a WinRE USB recovery media. Make sure the WinRE USB, which is the default option, is ticked, and click on Next. If you can't see your USB drive right away, click on Show All Drives. Choose your USB drive and click on Next. Click on Next, then click on Create. And it has completed successfully. Click on Finish here. You can now use this USB drive as a bootable media. When you boot into your recovery media, you will have access to the Comet client. Log in with the client credentials, and you will be able to restore disks onto this new device. We will go through the steps to restore from the client later. Next, here is how you can create a WinRE ISO recovery media. Click on WinRE ISO, then click on Next. Select the location where you would like to save the ISO image. Click on Next when done, and then click on Next again. The ISO image is now being created. Click on Finish when done. The last option is Windows to Go. Since the steps to create a recovery media with Windows to Go are very similar to the first two, we will just point out some key things about it next. Windows to Go is an alternate option that allows you to create a full Windows boot environment. No customizations are applied to the generated Windows to Go boot drive. You should boot into this drive, then install Comet normally and use it to perform the recovery operations such as restoring data. You may also want to create a recovery environment in any other way. Either Windows or Linux can be used as a suitable recovery environment. Please check out our guide linked below for more information on other possible methods. After logging into the Comet client through your recovery media, you can now restore items following these steps. In the Comet client, click on Restore. Make sure that you're selecting the correct storage vault to restore from, then click on Next. Choose the backup type you want to restore. If you have run more than one backup, you will see several versions here. Click on Next after you've selected the snapshot to restore. Here, you can choose the restore type you need. There are four ways you can restore from a disk image backup with Comet. You can restore disks or partitions back to a physical endpoint. You can restore selected files or folders back to a physical endpoint. Or you can restore disks or partitions as a virtual or a VMware disk file. We will go through all of these restore types, starting with restoring disks and partitions to a physical device. Since we will be restoring the image directly onto this computer, the target disk or partition should be unmounted. Comet may be able to do this automatically from your current booted OS if no programs are using the target drive. Select the backup source from the left and a restore target on the right. Take note that when you try restoring a smaller partition into a larger one, Comet will automatically extend the restored file system to fill the target partition. However, you cannot restore a large backed up partition into a smaller partition. Once you have made your selection, click on Add to Restore Queue. Finally, click on Restore. Now, let us restore individual files and folders to a physical device. Choose Granular Restore and click on Next. Click on the disk to show the directories and individual files and folders. Click on Next after you have made your selection. Here, type in where you would like to restore your backup in the local device. Click on Restore when done. Now, let us restore our disk image backup as virtual disk in files and as VMware virtual disks. With these two options, you first need to restore it to your device and then restart the disk image within the virtual machine or within the VMware. First, let us perform a disk image restore as virtual disk files. If we restore as virtual disk files, you will see that it will be in VMDK format. There is one plain text VMDK descriptor file representing metadata about the whole drive, plus separate raw image files for each partition's extent on the disk. Click on Next to choose items to restore. You can either restore all items or select disks or partitions to restore. If a partition was selected for backup, it would have a corresponding data file. If a partition was not selected for backup, there will be no corresponding data file. The data files have the same file size as the partition they are from. But if there was some unused space inside that partition, it will be all zeros and will be compressed by the storage vault. However, it is the full size when you go to restore the VMDK file. Click on Next after you have made your selection. Select the location to restore to and click on Restore. Once the restore finishes, you will find the VMDK files in your local device. It is possible to convert them to other formats such as VHD. You can attach the VMDK disk image files to a new or existing virtual machine. Check out our guide linked below for more on this. Now, let us restore our disk image backup as a VMware virtual disk. This restore process is similar, only the entire disk image backup is restored as a VMware virtual disk. Choose VMware virtual disk here and click on Next. Type in the location in the device where you would like to restore it to and click on Restore. Once the restore finishes, you will find the VMDK files in your local device. And we have come to the end of the tutorial. Please check out the link below to access our detailed documentation on backing up and restoring disk image with Comet. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.